My dear friends in Christ Jesus, greetings to you all. In this episode, I like to share with you something about the code of canon law of the Latin Catholic Church. At the beginning of the 20th century, in 1917, a codified system of law was promulgated for the Roman Catholic Church throughout the world. This code was modeled after the Napoleonic codes. In fact, at the beginning of the 20th century, these Napoleonic codes were used for civil governance in Europe. With this codification of church law under Pope Pius X and Pope Benedict XV for the first time, it proved to be a single comprehensive source for easy reference. This code is also called as Pio Benedictine Code. It consisted of 2,414 canons and served as the primary legal tool for canonies or church lawyers for several decades. The influence of the European civil law of the 19th century on the Pio Benedictine Code of Canon Law, and similarly, the influence of the Code of Canon Law on the constitution of certain nations provide interesting subjects for academic purposes and comparative studies of law. New norms and regulations were also required to address the needs of an evolving church in a constantly changing world. Pope St. John XXIII announced his momentous decision in 1959 to convene an ecumenical council, that is, the Second Vatican Council. At the same time, he called for a revision of the 1917 Code of Canon Law. This revision of the church law, incorporating the theological perspectives based on the deliberations of the Second Vatican Council, took 18 years to complete after the close of the council under Pope Saint John Paul II. Hence, a new code was promulgated with remarkable changes in 1983. My dear friends, as I have already shared with you, there are 24 sui juris churches, that is, self-governing churches in the Catholic Church. Today, the canon law for Roman Catholics is found primarily in a single volume called the Code of Canon Law of 1983. This code consists of 1,752 canons, or a major set of rules, divided into 7 books. As this single volume is capable of regulating most of the juridical aspects of the spiritual life of Roman Catholics around the world and is known for its brevity and clarity, the Code of Canon Law of 1983 is considered to be a remarkable achievement in the annals of the Church. Thanks for watching. See you again.